Spanish colonial period, American colonial, post-colonial period, and contemporary art period. All this that happens in the Philippines is fairly knowledgeable to the Filipinos nowadays. But when it comes to the field of arts in the pre-colonial period, I don't think the same could be said. Which is a shame actually. Because even before the coming of two foreign races colonizers, we were pretty much sleeping in the breathable paradise. Now let's look up some of the compelling reasons why arts in the pre-colonial period are also blossoming.
Pre-colonial era, the ancient Filipinos had expressed paintings through tattoos. Tattooing was practiced in pre-colonial Philippines both for the purpose of ornamentation and rite of passage. This was particularly well known in the Western Visayas and among the highland tribes of Northern Luzon. So widespread is the practice of tattooing in Visayas that the Spaniards coined the Visayans pintados because their bodies were covered with tattoos.
The Manunggo jar as a vessel history. The Manunggo jar was one of the most numerous jars found in a cave believed to be a burial site that was discovered on March 1964. The Manunggo jar was unique in all respects.
Baybayin. Baybayin is a pre-Spanish Philippine writing system. The term baybayin is literally means to spell in Tagalog. It is extensively documented by the Spanish. Some have attributed it to the name Alibata, but that name was incorrect. Baybayin is one of a dozen or so individual writing systems used in Southeast Asia. Nearly all of them are abugidas, wherein any consonant is pronounced with an inherent vowel A following it. Once again, baybayin. One of the pre-colonial writing system used by the early Filipinos.
Before the colonizers from Europe reached the islands, the different tribes and kingdoms wore their respective clothing. The Philippine style of clothing had been dictated by the tropical climate in the Philippines, with a dry and rainy season. Early Filipinos, as well as the still extant tribal groups in the Philippines, wore colorful woven clothes, often with intricate beadwork and other ornaments. But not until
what's your religion? Now you're a Catholic. We can now be friends.
Art forms were primarily influenced by religion and secularization in these times. Spaniards uses art to propagate Catholic faith.
The architecture of the Philippines, or in Spanish, Arquitectura Filipina, is the reflection of the country's historical and cultural heritage. During 330 years of Spanish colonization, Philippine architecture was dominated by Spanish influences. The Augustinian friars, along with other religious orders, built a large number of grand churches and cathedrals all over the Philippine Islands.
Dancing was considered a religious activity among the early Filipinos. Dances were performed by the priests and priestesses in thanksgiving for a plentiful harvest, a victorious battle, a prosperous voyage or recovery from sickness.
Yeter, the Spaniards have brought their unique force of entertainment into the country. This entertainment have helped shape the landscape of Philippines' theater and culture. With the introduction of Comedia, Marmoro, and others, people have newer ways in which to gain merriment. This new entertainment also provides a means in which to express deeper insight into daily society.